Okay, let me try that again. Hi guys, Dotsya here, and welcome back to Deadly Premonition, Director's Cut Edition. In the previous episode, we fished out evidence from the lake. It seems to be pointing that Thomas might be the raincoat killer. Now we're gonna find out if that's true. It's just my headphones were off, turned off. And for some reason, I didn't turn them on in time, so I kept crashing, which is odd. That games crash when headphones are off. Okay. Okay, so now it's working. Okay, it's all good. Wait a second. Alright, now we can finally start playing the game. 13th Bell, Chapter 18, Episode 3.
Previously during the investigation.
So, you want to find out everything there is to.
Supposed to head again home. We're back at the station. To the station. Ooh. Wait, how do you change the music? It just always plays the same one. This music reminds me of driver games. Like a spy show.
No, nothing. Just my imagination.
Ooh. Go here. It's not gonna work, is it? It might have worked. Oh shit. Really? Well, that's dumb. That's really dumb. Who would have thought? Ah, place to sleep. What the hell? Damn, so they would go all the way there? Drift to. That's not what I want to do. Oh hell yeah, it's working. Sort of. It's like less than. Oh shit, it's like a week away when they're supposed to release the actual release of WoW Classic. Hopefully by then I'll beat this game, and then I can switch to playing World of Warcraft.
Nothing. Just my imagination.
This guy's always talking to himself. Ah, I missed it. Which means it's not important. There's no possible way I would have missed it if it was important. Levels, shortcuts. Bullshito is this? Oh, it's a train. What the heck? Why is it sitting there? Two trains, actually. Or is that three?
Zach, we can take a rest if you're tired.
Oh, boy. That's unacceptable. What the hell, doing a spin? Ah, nice.
Nothing. Just my imagination.
Dude, come on. Cars don't stop when they hit inclines like this. Second climbs. Should have jumped there.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
That was a funny.
Looks like the next game is hide and seek.
Huh? Oh dear. I don't recognize that music anywhere. Uh. shadows in there, aren't there? The music is telling me yes. Oh, this is like...
These girls, Zach. Do you see the resemblance? Anna, Becky, she looks like Diane, and Carol. Zach, look. Emily.
What the heck? Can't climb over fallen statues. That's just not how survival horror games work. You're not allowed. Move it to my toolbox. Yes. So difficult. How could you possibly have made me do this? Love me, lady.
Yes. Close
down here. Goodbye, lady. This aiming thing is more difficult than it looks. It seems simple, but it's kind of like all... Inside a building. the last of our warriors, I guess. Let's sleep it off. 3 hours of sleep should be fine. When you do auto aim, he aims at the crotch for some reason. Maybe it's because they do the head thing. Then it's a weaker hit that way. Like this.
Amazing.
Great.
Like this is stronger.
Yes. Than. Amazing. Nice shot.
You're not scaring me. Gonna get my $30. That's just rude. What do you want to attack me for?
Nice shot. Bullseye.
Oh, he sounds so ridiculous when he does it. Something else will loot you too. Come on, dude. Dude. What the heck?
Bullseye. Amazing.
No, you can definitely put him into the toolbox. Agent. Not a special.
Great. Nice shot.
That makes sense, but it's okay. One day everything will make sense. I don't even have a magnum. Don't I? Bullets for weapons you don't have. This is starting to become like Alone in the Dark, my new nightmare. That's usually how it goes. Alright, so here. Oh, you can't open this door. That's too bad. No. Yes. Yes, I want to save. Oh yes, just put your hand and touch the stuff. Seriously, dude? It's kinda very gross, actually. Dude, come on. Just skip to the finish already. Alright, I can't go here. Unfortunately. Maybe this is where I came from. More fighting, I guess. That didn't do anything. It's kind of funny. Managed to damage myself. That was pretty close, so I'm not surprised.
Great. Nice shot. Bullseye. Great. Amazing. Nice shot.
Yes, please put it in the toolbox.
Nice shot. Yes, amazing.
Counting. Oh dear. I don't know, zombie lady can open doors. Shadow lady, zombie lady. She just wants a hug. That's all they're doing. They're just giving you hugs. Giving us hugs. It's gotta be wrong. Just last time this door was closed, right? Since this time it's open, I wonder if we could go. That's the sound he's making. He's not as dumb as usually. I did miss something. Since I was over there, but not over here. Nope.
Nope. Huh?
The heck?
Emily!
At times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist, even if it means losing someone you love.
Stop!
Stop! I have a gun, but I'm just gonna wave my hand around.
Zach, did you see that? I must be getting tired.
Let's try one button at a time. As that. And we descend. Oh.
Zach. Looks like we're out of the countryside and back in civilization.
Welcome, York.
Welcome indeed. Well, he locked the door.
I brought the documents. Just what is going on in here?
I warned you about haste. Take it slow. You'll lose sight of what's important if you just rush past it. As an agent of the FBI, I'm sure you know. So many people have got it all wrong. They think speed is the key. That being first is the best. They want speed, and are satisfied with what the speed brings. Even if it means that they miss so much on the way, they don't even see that. I see everything that they don't. From here, I see it all. Then, when the time comes, I make use of what I've seen. I can get whatever I want in this way. Anything at all.
You're certainly talkative today, Harry. But I didn't come here for a business lecture. Tell me everything you know.
Speed is not important. Timing is what is important. Timing. York, you have a natural gift for waiting for the correct timing. Just be careful that your haste does not ruin everything. That will be vital to solving the current case at hand. York, I know more than you think, but less than what you hope. One, you have Nick in custody. Two, Thomas is missing. Three, Carol has a locket that belongs to the murderer. I also know that this case revolves around the Red Seeds. But that's about it.
So you've got an inside line on police information.
That reminds me. The victim's tongues were cut out, weren't they? But that's only a minor point. Don't let the shocks blind you to what's more important. That's another business tip.
Harry, I'm impressed. You gather information really well. You hacked into the FBI network, too. Amazing. But I didn't come here to hear this.
Then let us close the business seminar. It's time for a history lesson instead. I remember it as though it were yesterday, if you'll pardon the cliché. It was dark, raining, a foggy night. My parents, who normally got along, were fighting over something. My father was blaming my mother, it seemed. So I left the house, headed for the clock tower. There was a party being held that day to celebrate the tower's completion. I wanted to see the town from above, and so I decided to climb the tower. Curious child. I saw it being constructed day after day. I'm not sure why, but I was really drawn to the tower in some way. And that's why I knew. From the pit in the theater, there's a path to the clock. They were just cleaning up after the party, so it was easy to get into the theater. I used the secret passage to sneak into the tower. But when I reached the top, I saw something very strange. There were soldiers there, all wearing gas masks. Device was emitting purple smoke outside. Just say, for the first time, the bell rang throughout the town. I reacted with fear. Left the tower as fast as I could. When I got outside again, the purple fog was spreading. I covered my nose and mouth and ran home. I unconsciously counted the number of times the bell rang. After the 12th time, the bell did not stop ringing. It rang a loud 13th time. I got back into town to see another, even more disturbing sight. The following morning, I awoke surrounded by dead bodies. It wasn't raining anymore, and the purple fog was gone. I couldn't believe what I saw and what I myself had done. But even worse things were waiting for me when I got home. My mother was dead. Killed, presumably, also by my father. The next day, the town was overrun by military personnel. That's when the gag order was issued. Talking about the incident was unappreciated, a taboo. But even still, people stopped going outside when it rained. Country folk are very patriotic. We never tell our children about what happened. But these things find a way out of even the tightest of lips, in parts. People only speak of the killer in the red raincoat, which is where the legend of the raincoat killer comes from.
Quite a story.
After the incident, the gas seeped into the soil of the town. Even today, when it rains, a minute amount is released. That's why I never take my mask off when I'm outside. This town is dirty, York.
If what you say is true, then the killer is someone who is badly affected when it rains.
You need to draw the conclusions, not I. I have no conclusions.
Is there a connection between the red seeds and the gas, then?
This is just my own presumption. The seeds and the gas have a similar effect on our nervous systems. I believe someone figured that out and decided to use it. Or it could just be nature's way of getting back at us humans.
Isn't that what they always say?
York! Good news! You'll hear from George soon. They have found tell you one last and very important thing. Just as you suspected, everything I have told you is gibberish. I never hacked into the FBI server, and I certainly know nothing about the Red Seeds. I shall thank you for listening to an old man babble on.
Oh, of course.
Let me ask you one thing then, Harry. You're a businessman. You must be after something in return for giving me this information.
York, at times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
But that still does not justify murder.
Remember this. Everything changes in form. There isn't a single thing that can maintain its shape for eternity. Overlook this fact, and you'll be making a big, big mistake.
Okay, so, what is it, like, military experimentation here with the gas, or what's going on?
York, we found Thomas.
Ah, he's at his house, right?
How did you know that?
Timing, Emily. Good timing.
Whatever. Just get in. George is heading over there already. Let's get a move on.
It'd be funny if I stopped in the middle of the road and
check. Things are finally starting to come together. All we need now is for Thomas to fill in the blanks in our new legend.
Crazy, and it turns a lot better. What kind of car is this? I mean, before all the other cars just ass, this is like a lot better. And what the hell? Wait, does it go faster? Yeah, whoa, cars usually go 50 miles per hour, this one's going crazy fast. What the fuck? Oh, you're supposed to make it an hour and a half, that's why they gave you this car. That's what it feels like. It feels like they're toy boxes. It doesn't feel like they have any weight to them at all. The vehicles you drive. Yeah, if this car was going 60 miles an hour, it would definitely go through more than just a few fences.
George, what's happening?
We received an anonymous call informing us that Thomas returned home. I sent Emily to get you right away.
No idea who made the call?
No. That's why I came on ahead, to see if the information was correct. A light did come on, but only for a second. I saw a tall male silhouette in the window. It was Thomas.
Okay. I'm going in then. You two wait here.
We'll be ready to burst in at any moment. Just call out.
They're standing in the rain with guns. Blazing.
Zach, blazing. It's the same in the countryside after all. The climax of an investigation is always in an apartment. Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Do you have to say that every single time? Like, quite literally every single time? So Thomas was pretending to be the girl? Maybe he's... I mean, the way he runs... Nope, too early. What? Thomas is biscuit. There's a joke in there somewhere. But I'm gonna say it. Thank you. more, then we'll profile. I don't know why it keeps doing that. There's no point in doing it before you have all the pieces. So why even bother asking? Coffee. See if I can recognize the notes. It's so difficult to tell. That's one thing. She takes care of its thematic and she always requests. Wait, so this wasn't Thomas's apartment? Why did it make it sound like he would return home? What the hell? Because he said she. Is that about the girl or is that, or is he transgender or something? What is going on? Something freakish going on here. Nope, there we go. Thomas's shoes. Okay, that makes more sense. Uh-huh. Why Thomas behaves this way.
So, Thomas wants us to look around for him a bit more. So there's more to it. Kind of like the bonus footage on a DVD. I hope it's worth watching. Don't you agree, Zach?
York? What was that noise? Damn it! We need to seal off all routes out of town.
What the hell?
No need for that, George.
Huh?
If he was going to leave town, he would have done so by now. Which means he's still got some unfinished business.
I kind of figured. I thought he would be gay or something. I didn't think he would be like this. Although I'm not sure if he's, what do you call them? Drag queen, or that's what they call them, right? Or a transsexual. I'm not sure what the heck's going on.
Zach, do you think they heard what I said?
Quickly. Cars generally don't accelerate.
We don't have to make a fuss. Thomas isn't going to leave town.
One car.
That gives us plenty of time to find a way to view the bonus footage. Probably save over here. That doesn't really matter. I could just. What the hell? They literally put. What the fudge? Kind of figured they would be. I didn't think they would be just in the middle of the streets. What the crap. It's quite fascinating. Extra enemy skills, yes! So, where shall we go next?
a hospital.
Is that Anna?
Sometimes they call her Anna, sometimes Anna. With two N's, I already said this before. Usually people say Anna. With one N, it's Anna. Though it sounds like it's the opposite. At least that's from all the names I ever heard. I have a lot of Annas in our family. Quite a number of them. I was called Anna. Okay, so.
This way, Zach. We need to keep her in sight.
Well, she kind of disappeared. Keep her here. So I quite literally have to run. There she is. That's just so weird. Huh? Her ghost is telling us. Or her spirit is challenged to follow her. He runs the exact same way, Thomas, I mean, as this chick. What the crap? Whoa. What the fuck was that? Stop here. Seriously, dude?
Not this way, Zach.
She is in there. She just keeps going around. Okay. What is the point of just going around and around? Am I supposed to do something? Okay, now she's going here. Now she's not going anywhere. Uh-huh. Huh? Oh, great. Not more random. Of course he's gonna. Why are you standing around for it now?
I almost became a goddess of the forest myself. Although I think the look might suit me. What do you think, Zach?
Lol, that's what I think. That has flies buzzing around him now. Time to change clothes, my dear lad. Do it.
Too much noise. You're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Oh shit. You literally just started. Of course you're missing. A lot. Guess one tomato is a lot. What's that noise? Oh no. Break down the door and then I have to hide again. Oh, something else. Oh dear.
I see you.
Nice to run with. Get the heck out of there, dude. save first. That's funny if I can hide under the table. So I have to press left control, right? To hold my breath. What is the point of hiding under that table? It's ridiculous. How will he not see me? Funny how he didn't notice the fly flying around me.
Zach, this is a waste of time. Let's go.
It's a waste of time to preserve your own life? Oh, okay. Guess we should just let this guy catch us then. I know exactly what he means. I'm just being silly. Wasting too much time sitting around. Well, another red door. Oh, fuck. Oh. I didn't think he was gonna press this button. No. The right way. Yeah, dude, you gotta. I don't understand how that didn't do much. It would be like this. That was the right way, but it was a bit confused. It's locked. Oh no. How can this be?
Huh?
Just like the ghosts of the people who died back in the 60s or 50s, whenever that was. Ah, not this again. I thought she only appeared in one part of the map. Crap. Forever to kill. Ugh, man, these monsters are annoying. It's like enough already. I don't want to constantly fight this one. She's just gonna keep appearing, huh? It takes like a shit ton of bullets to kill it. Come on, you silly creature. Thank you. either. Hey, lady. Difficult thing to kill is just annoying. No more. This is the third one. After this, let's not do this anymore. It's like that. Am I going back? Please tell me this is the right way. No, it's not the right way. Guess I was there. Oh dear. Yes, finally. know, adding more enemies does not make the game more interesting. At least not to me. Unless it's like an action game. Survival horror games with a lot of monsters just kind of gets annoying. An action game is just like, yes, kill as many of them as you can. Okay. See what I mean? He just spins and goes like... Yes. Freaking A. It looks... What's this? It's not gonna open the door, huh? Until I do everything correctly. Mm-hmm. What exactly I'm supposed to turn on and off?